All right, good evening. Saturday night at the Belasco Theater in Los Angeles. What a treat to see Dope, Fear Factory, and Statc X all at the same time. Be sure to check out those other videos. They're all posted in their entirety. Right now, I want to talk about Dope. Let's talk about Dope a little bit. Edsel Dope and his brother selling dope in New York, where the name comes from. Edsel Dope is just a cool name. I really like it. Also known as Zero, the masked singer in Statc X. And I think it's only fitting that he's the guy, even though no one admits it. I think we all kind of know. But just dope in their own right. You know, such an epic band. They've got a nice industrial sound. I just love the vibe of it. It's awesome. Kind of has like a Ministry vibe. A little bit of Marilyn Manson going on. And Die Motherfucker Die, you know. That's the chant song when people in Iraq were going to war. That's the song they played. I think they've also used it for other things in the military. Probably interrogating, you know, prisoners, whatever, you name it. It's a pretty hardcore song. I also like My Funeral, believe it or not. Not one of their most popular songs. I think it's great. And the grand finale, after they were done with their set, the last song, You Spin Me Round, with a dope spin on it, which was a surprise to me. I was surprised they actually played that, but what wasn't a surprise was the crowd. The crowd was off the hook. They were into it from the second those guys went on stage, and they were electrifying. So anyway, enjoy the show.
Los Angeles, California, what the fuck is going on? We'll be right back.
I go any further, I want to say from the four of us and all the other bands backstage, thank you to every single one of y'all that came out here tonight. We very much appreciate it. This was one of the first shows on the tour that sold the fuck out like a fucking close to a year ago or some shit. And we wanted them to move the tour, move the show to the Wilter. But unfortunately, they had another show tonight. So you're the lucky motherfuckers, because there's a whole bunch of assholes outside going, shit! Shit! So anyway, on that note, thank you all again. Are you guys having a good time so far tonight? You got a lot of shit for your money tonight. We kept this whole tour together all the way through COVID. You got Twisted, you got Dope, you got Fear Factory, you got Statc X, and we got all you motherfucking mental patients. Great goddamn shit, Los Angeles. Well, we're gonna keep playing you some more shit. How about that? All right, I know we're a little older than we used to be, and I know it's L.A., I know it's early. We're gonna do a little bit of cardio with you motherfuckers. Let me see you bounce with me, just a little. Come on.
Yeah.
appreciate the fuck out of it, though. Thank you. That was very nice of you. On that note, probably a really stupid question, but I have to ask it every night. How many of y'all motherfuckers are familiar with who the hell we are? Okay, that's good. That means I didn't completely waste the last 25 years of my life. So how many of y'all know that we just put out a brand new album about a month or so ago? Alright, well, those of you who do and those of you who don't, you can go to Spotify and you can listen to the old shit and you can listen to the new shit, all in the same motherfucking place. I happen to be a big fan of Spotify, even though they don't pay us shit, they still, like, that's a good place to go find lots of cool music and make playlists and shit. I'm not mad at it. I like technology. How about you guys? You guys are quiet as shit. You know, the first time I took my future wife to see my band play was in Michigan. Those motherfuckers are weird. Let me just be straight. And she stood side stage and watched the concert, and afterwards she said, "Your fans are mental patients." That's what she told me. She's not lying. You guys might be in LA, but you're a bunch of fucking mental patients too. I'm telling you. And I'm still grateful for every one of you crazy motherfuckers. So look here. We're gonna drop a bomb right in the middle of this floor on this next song. So if you didn't come to get fucked up, you're gonna wanna move the fuck out of the way, all right? Are you guys ready to get this fucking thing started tonight? Cause you got Fear Factory and Statc X coming up. We gotta fuck this shit up. This one's called Die, Motherfucker.
Say I, say I, oh,
1999, and there was this really badass fucking band that had already been doing it for several fucking years. They were taking heavy metal and mixing it with industrial and electronics and all kinds of really fucking cool shit, and they were called Fear Factory. You remember those? And at the same time in 1999, there was this little baby fucking two bands that most of the country had never heard of before. Maybe a few of y'all did because one of them was from here. Those two baby bands were called Statc X and Dope. You remember that? So, in 1999, Fear Factory put a tour together and they decided, you know what, we're going to take Statc X and Dope, we're going to put them out with us, bring them around and introduce them to our fans. That was the first time that I had the pleasure of meeting what would become my lifelong friends in Kenny, Koichi, Tony, and of course, Mr. Wayne Static, who's no longer with us. And dare I say, had it not been for that first tour we did together, we became such good friends, and all the touring that we did thereafter, that tonight would probably not be fucking possible. So, thank you to Dino from Fear Factory for bringing all of us together in that 2009. And thank you to all you crazy mental patient motherfuckers for being in here tonight and remembering this shit and having a good time with us. We appreciate every single one of you all. Now see, I can rewind the clock back to 1999, and most of y'all, if you came out back then, you were in like high school or some shit, maybe junior high school. So like, the biggest problem you had that day was like, who's got a car that can drive to the show and who's got some weed that we can smoke in the parking lot before the show? And now what? Motherfucker had to get a babysitter to come here tonight. You probably had to take a goddamn day off work. You circled your calendar like a year ago and went, that is the fucking night that I'm gonna go out and get fucking drunk as shit with all my friends and party my fucking ass off. So, what I'm trying to tell you, Los Angeles, is that you're fucking old. That's what I'm trying to tell you. But the truth of the matter is that probably makes me older than you. But what I'm really trying to say is that I fucking appreciate you that much more, because I know what you had to go through to get here tonight. So thank you again, every one of y'all, for taking the time to make this shit happen tonight. So on that note, I think we've established the fact that tonight is a party, a celebration, a reason to get away from all the serious bullshit in your life, correct? Well, I don't know about you, but from where I come from, it ain't a party till somebody puts their dick in the goddamn mashed potatoes. So, don't worry, ladies, it's 2023. We're in L.A. You can have dicks, too. It's all good. It's proverbial. They're not real dicks. Everybody in the room's got a dick. You can have the biggest dick in the room. It's all good. No judgment. We're all gonna put our dicks in the mashed potatoes together. How about that? Can we do that together? Anyway, Los Angeles, thank you. I'm going to play you the stupidest fucking song you've ever heard in your entire goddamn life. Get your hands up in the air with me if you came to party tonight. Get them up in the air. Let me see you bounce with me.
So much fun.